welcome for the online church service. We want to give glory to God for whoever is watching, wherever you are. And let's say a word of prayer as we invite the Holy Spirit. Mukama kitange twagala okwebaza. Tusiimye okubeera mu maaso go, tuli basanyufu, tujja n'emitima emisanyufu. Era kitange nga tuyimba, nga tukutendereza, nga tukusinza okuyita mu nnyimba zino. Tata Simo okusinza kwaffe. We give you glory for whoever is watching, and we pray that you touch their hearts as they worship together with us. In the name of Jesus.
Tewalirinya wabula eria Yesu. Tewalirinya wabula ye Mukama. Tewalirinya wabula ye Yesu. Tukuye Musa Yesu, wekatondo wamanye, tukuwa echitiwa netendo. Tewalirinya wabula eria Yesu. Tewalirinya wabula ye Mukama. Tewalirinya wabula ye Yesu. Tukuye Musa,
tukuye Musa Yesu,
we Katonda, wamanyi tukuwa echitibwa netendo. Tewalirinya,
tewalirinya
wabula
Yesu.
Tewalirinya,
tewalirinya
wabula
ye Mukama.
Tewalirinya wabula ye Yesu. Tukuye Musa,
tukuye Musa Yesu,
we Katonda wa
amani,
tukuwa
tukuwa
echitibwa netendo. Tewalirinya wabula ye Mukama. Tana tukulumiza, katugamba tewalirinya, si ku nsi, si mukulu, si wakulu. Tukuye Musa, we Katonda wa echitibwa netendo. Tewalirinya wabula eria Yesu. Tewalirinya wabula ye Mukama. Osani Katonda wate,
tukuwe
echitibwa,
echitibwa netendo.
No other name,
no other name, but the name of Jesus. No other name, but the name
but the name of Jesus. Worthy of glory, Lord, you are worthy of honor,
you are
worthy of power. Of power and no praise,
no other name but the name of Jesus.
No other name,
no other name
but the name of the Lord. No other name but the name of Jesus.
You are worthy of
glory,
worthy of
honor,
worthy
of power,
and no praise.
His name is exalted far above the earth. His name is high above the heavens. His name is exalted far above the earth. Give glory and honor and praise unto his name.
No other name but the name of Jesus.
There is no other name,
no other name but the name of the Lord. No other name but the name of Jesus.
Osanidde okusinzibwa, tugamba oluyimba lulwo, okusinza kukwo, amatendo gago, tukuyimusa, gwe Katonda wange.
Tewali linnya wabula ye Mukama. Tewali linnya wabula ye Yesu.
Tukuyimusa
Yesu,
gwe
Katonda w'amaanyi.
Kala tukuyimusa waggulu ennyo, tukuyimusa waggulu ennyo, nga tugamba teri linnya liri nga liryo, teri linnya ligoba mizimu, teri linnya liwonya balwadde, teri linnya ligabirira, nedda teririnnya 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 ngo jeke liryo teririnnya mukulu n'ensi bakusinza tugambo webwenge ekitiibwa owebwenga amatendo kubanga mazima ddala gweweka 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 teririnnya kabaka wabakabaka liringa liryo teririnnya mukama wabakama liringa liryo Osani dejitibwa n'amatendo, osani dokusinza kwa fe. Owe bwenga echitibwa. Owe bwenga amatendo erinyali. Gatu chinyo Yesu elinyalyo liyamu wendo Owe bwenga echitibwa
Owe bwenga echitibwa
Owe wa matendo
Owe
Tata owe bwe chitibwa
Owe bwenga Echitibwa
Owe bwa matendo
Owe bwenga Ama
Elinyalyo
Elinyalyo
Dunji
Atunjinyo Yesu
matendo
owe bwenga
amatendo owe wechitibwa
owe bwenga
owe chitibwa owe bwamatendo
owe bwenga
amatendo owe wechitibwa name that can do miracles. We thank you, O King of Kings.
byowa webale ku lw'ekyo kyokola mu bulamu bwaffe webale ne mu kunyigirizibwa obeerawo webale ne mu ssanyu obeerawo webale ne mu maziko obeerawo webale 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 olw'erinnya eryo gye tuddukira ne tuwonyezebwa webale olw'erinnya eryo gye tuddukira taata ebyafa ne bizuukira webale olw'erinnya eryo webale olw'erinnya eryo. Thank you for the name Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. I welcome you from that beautiful time of worship. When we worship, we touch the heart of God. We bless the Lord for today. And here we are with the message. The word of God. How can we maintain faith amidst times of uncertainty? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's open up with a word of prayer. Father in heaven, we want to thank you. Thank you for this new day. Thank you for the grace you've given us to share your eternal truth. As we minister to your people, Lord, increase, O God, in our lives and help us decrease. In the name of God, Jesus, take away every pride. Take away every fear. Arise, O God, and let every enemy scatter. In the mighty name of Jesus, give your people receiving ears. The Lord, this word shall transform lives. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm very optimistic about life these days. Not because everything is working out very well, but because of this element of faith. I have faith that better days lie ahead. Amidst all uncertainties, amidst life's challenges, I want to believe God for the best. And if you are judging me based on what you see me today, I want to tell you you are wrong. Life ahead is going to be better. Good days lie ahead. I believe that in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We're going to share from the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, about the faith generals. The men who clinged on God at this part the times of uncertainty. And what do we learn from these men of God? The Abrahams, the general, all the patriarchs, Moses,
the Musa.
The men who lived by faith. Noah, Enoch. All these men lived by faith. And yet things are not certain. Some of us believe a lie. And maybe these ones, God made everything clear for them. I'm here to tell you, when you study scripture, it's very evident that not everything was clear. These people reached out to God by faith. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And God is challenging us to raise our faith in the challenging times we live in. Verse 1 says of Hebrews 11, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. ebitalabiddwa,
the evidence of things not seen,
obukakafu obw'ebintu ebitalabiddwa.
For by it the elders obtained good report.
Kubanga okuyita muku abaku abakadde bafuna report ennungi.
You know, seeing substance in things hoped for.
Omanyi okulaba esuubi, okulaba ekintu eky'omwendo mu bintu ebisuubirwa.
Having evidence of things not seen.
Bukakafu obw'ebintu ebitalabibuddwa.
So there was uncertainty.
Kati waliwo obutali bumativu, obutali bukakafu.
As we experience it today.
Nga bwe tukirowoozezzaako leero.
But they had faith.
Naye
they had faith in God. No wonder they took those steps, bold steps. And it's written about them that they obtained a good report. My version here says they obtained a good testimony. Maybe this comes as a challenge to all of us. Which testimony do you have? Amid your challenging times, do you have a testimony? Is there something that can be written about you? Let's stop being bogged down by the situations that are around us. We ought to believe our God for the impossibilities. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, oftentimes we are limited by what we can be able to deliver, what we can be able to do. And we forget the scripture that says that the greater is He that is in us. There is a great God in us. There is a God who can do exploits. And we better believe Him. We better have faith in Him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For me, I've come to realize that in the most difficult seasons, when my ability is failing, when my strength is failing, God has showed Himself strong on my behalf. And you know, that's what we see with the patriarchs. Let's continue to read on the story of faith. Verse 4 says, by faith Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous. God testifying of his gift. And through him, being dead, speaks up to today. Wow. Because of faith and the faith gift Abel gave, though being dead, still speaks. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let it be written about you. Although you are no more. Because of the steps you took of faith. Something still resonates. Something still sounds
echoes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
By faith, Enoch was taken away.
Orokukiriza Enoch ayatwalibwa.
So that he did not see death.
Nataloza kukufa.
And was not found. Because God had taken him. But before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. Enoch pleased God. You can't just please God. You must have walked with him. Enoch must have walked closely with God. And he pleased him. He was no more, just disappeared. And there's a testimony written about him.
He
was a God pleaser. May the Lord make us God pleasers. Men and women of faith. Men and women who have committed ourselves to walk closely with him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I love verse
6.
But without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a reward of those who diligently seek Him. We can just make God's face shine or smile. When we believe Him for that difficult situation, when we tell Him, God, you are able, we have personal limitations. We are just frail humanity. We are just weak people. But because you are God, you can move us to the directions and distances you want us to go. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is faith. Verse 7, by faith
Noah,
being divinely warned of the things not yet seen, moved with godly fear, prepared an ark for the saving of his household, by which he condemned the world, and became heir of the righteousness which is according to faith. There's still a lot of uncertainty here. God appears and tells this old man Noah, prepare an ark. I'm going to save you and your family. A great rain, a great storm is coming over. Lots of uncertainty. But amid this uncertainty, the man of God believed. Of course, other people didn't believe it. They looked up the sky, and it was all dry. No sign, no any signal of rain. Alas, the rain came. And it was a man of faith to float. And all that belongs to him. I got a deep meditation here. When we move in faith, as husbands, as mothers, as family heads, as church leaders, the people we work with, the people we superintend, the people we rule over, the people we cover, benefit immensely. They enjoy the privilege of walking in faith. So as a father, amid this challenging time, your people are looking up to you to get the best to glean out of your faith. Because it's obvious the benefits of faith shall come. Noah was such a man. A man of the heart of God. We shall stop with the 8. By faith Abraham. By faith Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to the place which he would receive as an inheritance. Another uncertainty. God speaks, and it's not very clear. It's not certain. The fuel that drives you is faith. If you don't have faith, you remain stuck. When he says you are going somewhere, you are going to achieve this and the other, you need the fuel of faith. If you lack faith, you don't move. You get worried. You think about the next step. The wild animals on the way. The financial needs. How am I going to make it? you know, the connections with your culture, your home. How am I going to leave my people? Abraham would have given these excuses. I'm born here. And my father is here in
Wool.
This is our kind of the way we worship. I can't leave my religion. As people often say when we preach to them. But he said, because of faith, I'm moving. I'm moving. And he was able to grab and take that inheritance. He went out not knowing where he was going. By faith he dwelt in the land of promise. As in a foreign country. Dwelling in tents with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs of him of the same promise.
Ngabera muwema zezimunga Isaac ne Yakobo abasajja abatabaini mukukiriza wamu naye.
Amen.
Amen.
When I read about tents,
when jogera kuwema,
it manifest it shows something temporary because if you want a shelter that is permanent, you build with bricks and mortar. But a tent is temporary. Anytime you are moving away. All these signals uncertainty.
It
was not there permanently.
It
was a man on the move. A pilgrim going somewhere. I'm not even sure where he was going. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the Lord help us. They are to step into the deep waters. Even where we are not certain. I remember when I started on my course. Oftentimes I give this example. I wasn't very sure. it was COVID-19. Lockdown and there was no money. And here I am. Registering for a course. That runs for years. I didn't even... I wasn't sure of. By God's grace, I got a
scholarship.
But still, I needed to pay in some money. Which is not small money. According to the standards here. But I tell you, God moved in on my behalf. And you know, I've been seeing God providing ways here and there. The travels I was supposed to, you know, pay a lot of money cancelled and spared of those expenses. And right now I'm almost nearing the finishing line. And because of His grace, I'll make it in Jesus' name. Because God rewards faith. If I'd looked at the expenses, the travels, money for books. There's what they call graduation fees. Things could not add up. There was virtually no money. But you know, he says, come and buy without money. That's what he says in Isaiah 55. Isaiah 55 verse 1 says, come all you who are thirsty. To the waters. You have no money. Come buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Wow, for me I picked something from there. God's mercy is sufficient. If you hold on to Him in faith, He can move mountains on our behalf. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amidst uncertainty, hold on to faith. Hold on to faith. And the Lord will come through for
you.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm excited about 2022. And I'm seriously picking Psalm
65:11.
Which says that he crowns the year with his bounty. I'm believing the bounty of the Lord before the end of this year. In the name of Jesus. Even where things fail at the beginning of the year. I want to grab Ecclesiastes 7:8.
Ekitabo ky'omulamuzi.
Omubulizi. Musanvu munana. That says that the end of the matter is better than its beginning.
Egamba enkomeke entandikwa y'ebintu nnungi okusinga enkomekerero yaabyo.
I'm not about to give up on what the Lord has started.
Wecho Katonda
ky'atandise. Although I'm quite uncertain,
newankubadde nga nganga,
I have confidence.
Nina obukakafu.
That I'll reach there. That I'll make it. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amina.
Where I cannot walk. I've seen the Lord carrying me up. Moving on his wings. Because of his mercy. I want to ignite your faith today. I want to ignite your faith. Handle what you can handle as a human being. And what you cannot handle. Leave it to God. Trust God to do it. In the name of Jesus. Concerning your health. Concerning your finances, concerning your relationship, concerning your marriage, concerning your children, concerning your ministry, there's a lot of uncertainty. I'm here to tell you, because of faith, there's a light in the tunnel. There's a light before the end of the tunnel. Somewhere in the tunnel there's a light. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And it is faith that is going to expose that light fully. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. You know, the patriarchs, you are bent on eternity. Their hearts are set on the pilgrim. They are going somewhere. Although that somewhere was uncertain, they had faith to reach there. I love the statement made by Jacob when he visited Egypt to see Joseph, his son. Yusuf, mutabani we.
Joseph's son.
And Jacob was ushered into the presence of Pharaoh. And hear what he says before Pharaoh. In Genesis 47:9. The years of my pilgrimage are 130.
Emyaka gy'obutambuze bwange giri 13.
He didn't say the years of my life.
Teyagamba emyaka gy'obulamu
bwange. The years of my pilgrimage.
Emyaka gy'okutambula kwa.
Meaning that he was going somewhere.
Ekitegeeza yalina gy'alaga.
A 130.
Giri 13.
I confess they've been few and difficult.
Agamba gibadde mizibu era nga mizito.
When I compare with my ancestors.
We njigerageranya ne baganda bange.
Ah, bajjajja bange.
Bajjajja bange.
Oh, bakadde bange.
Oh my.
Emyaka yali amaze 13.
He had lived 130 years.
Nenga mizibu.
But they were difficult years.
Bajjajjabe.
Their ancestors. Bo
babera minjiko.
They lived more than those years.
But what I want to pick from here.
But niche njagala okujja wano.
Is a fact that in this statement he's saying I'm a pilgrim.
Chechintu ekigamba nti nze ndi mutambuze.
And David echoes this again in Psalms 84:5. It says, blessed are those whose hearts are set on pilgrimage.
They are
going somewhere. They are going to eternity. Though it's uncertain. I know there are many unbelieving believers. They doubt this issue of eternity. No wonder many don't want to die. But I want to tell you, even eternity requires faith. Jacob calls himself a pilgrim. And David says, blessed are those whose hearts are set on the pilgrimage. Let's learn to believe God for the unbelievable. Let's have faith for the uncertainty. Because without faith, we can't please God. I want to pray for you, even as I conclude, that the Lord will ignite faith in you in the area of your faith. Family.
Maka.
There are some people who are cursed. The curses are following you.
And the
life is not certain. You have court cases. You entangled, you in a quagmire, you are stuck in a relationship. You incapacitated. You have issues at your place of work. You are wallowing in challenges. And the Lord is here to tell you, have faith in me. Have faith in my son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amid this uncertainty, raise your faith. Because when you raise your faith, you please the Lord. And the Lord will move mightily to work for you. I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you for the gift of faith you've given me, you've given the people watching. Our prayer right now is that you increase it. Ignite it in us, O God. In the name of Jesus, that you shall have confidence in you. You shall have faith in you. You shall have trust in you, O God. That you are able to handle a difficult situation. You shall be able to please you because of our faith. And the moment you smile, things will work well for us. You shall be released from bondages. You shall be forgiven of our sins. You shall have breakthroughs. Our body shall be healed. Somebody's business will be healed. Somebody's family will be healed because of faith. Encourage our faith, O God. Forgive us, O God, where our faith has failed. The Lord, you shall become God pleasers.
Those people please the Lord. We lift up your name. We worship you.
We bless your God. Because you are God. Even in an uncertain situation, you remain God. Even where we think you are not working, you are working behind the curtains for our own good. Thank you, Jehovah, for you are releasing someone who is watching me right now. Thank you, Father, for that's Jesus' mission. Isaiah 61, to set prison doors free, to open prison doors, to set prisoners free, to declare the year of acceptance. And some of the people who have been rejected shall be accepted. Your favor shall come upon them. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, Lord. Thank you for this ministry. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.